Imagine a train moving along a track, and someone on that train drops a ball. To an observer standing on the ground at a distance from the train, the ball will appear to move in an arc. But how does it look for the person on the train? Let's imagine the ground is moving while the train is stationary and see what happens. Interesting. The ball appears to drop in a straight line. So which one of these perspectives is right? Does the ball move in a straight line, or does it move in an arc? Well, it turns out that neither of these are correct, or they are both equally correct. This idea of motion relative to perspective is called special relativity. Special here doesn't mean it got the most participation trophies growing up. It just means it's a limited or specified case compared to general relativity. One foundational principle for this theory is the constancy of the speed of light. If the person on our train held a lantern, the light from the lantern would not be added to the velocity of the train. Light moves at the same speed no matter what, and countless observations have confirmed this. From here, we should—
Lightning!
Whoa, did two lightning bolts just simultaneously crash on both sides of our observers? Well, actually not really. For our observer on the ground, the light from each lightning strike will reach the observer at the same time and will be perceived as simultaneous. For our observer on the train, however, because the train is moving relative to the lightning bolts, the train will have moved some small distance towards the bolt R by the time the light from it reaches him, meaning that the bolt L will appear delayed. Thus, we find that an event which is simultaneous for the observer on the ground is not simultaneous for the observer in a relatively moving system. This can be more generally stated as time in one system is not the same as time in the other. In fact, it has been demonstrated that if we place a clock in a moving system for a while, and then bring it back to the stationary system, less time will have passed for the clock that was in the moving system. So what does any of this have to do with a racing game? Bear with me for a moment. It turns out that time isn't the only thing that changes between perspectives. Lengths also undergo a change called length contraction. This means that if you have two rods of equal length, and give one to the observer on the ground and one to the other on the train, from the perspective of the ground, the rod on the train will actually appear shorter along the axis of movement. Likewise, the rod on the ground will appear shorter to the observer on the train because it is moving relative to him. Length contraction is a result of the difference of simultaneity between moving systems, but the effects are minuscule enough that they are not noticed in everyday life. It's only when a moving system approaches the speed of light that it becomes noticeable. I thought these principles provided an interesting basis for creating a game that uses length contraction between different perspectives. After some consideration, a racing game seemed the most appropriate because it would be cool to make obstacles that have changing dimensions depending on the player perspective. With that said, let's get into the project. We'll need a vehicle to start, and preferably one that isn't constantly doing a wheelie. I thought a sort of hovercraft would look cool, so let's try that. The hovering works, but I didn't intentionally add this earthquake simulation feature. We can worry about that later. Is it able to navigate some obstacles? Yeah, that looks pretty good. I felt inspired by this old game I used to play called Race the Sun, and I settled on a similar movement system with constant forward velocity and left-right drifting. Here that is with a few more obstacles. Let's improve the physics a bit and add some ramp detection. Cool, that's looking like a good foundation. Let's try to add in length contraction using these equations called Lorentz transformations. Okay, that isn't quite how it should look. I'll make some adjustments and change the obstacles affected by contraction to a different color. And I should also mention that I've set the speed of light close to the speed of the vehicle in order to actually perceive the length contraction that's happening. You can most clearly see the contraction happening with these longer walls at the end as the vehicle moves side to side. As we already discussed, contraction happens in the direction of the movement. So if the walls are longer on the x-axis and the vehicle moves on the x-axis, then that is where the contraction will be most apparent. I'm breaking a few rules here by allowing acceleration of the vehicle and its side-to-side movement, and also the white surfaces are unaffected by length contraction. But these seem like necessary decisions for creating something that's playable. I'd like to have three perspectives in total. One for the vehicle, one for a stationary perspective relative to the white surfaces, and one for x-axis movement relative to the white surfaces. At first, I had the camera move to show perspective swaps, but this was a bit too disorienting, so I added some underglow to the vehicle to show the current perspective. The two final mechanics I added were speed pickups to increase vehicle velocity, and these transparent walls that can only be passed if they are thin enough. This makes use of length contraction along the z-axis, and it also means you have to be moving fast enough to be able to pass them. With all these elements in place, I did some polishing and added a few levels. Here's the full game in action. The game could certainly use a lot more polish, and it would be interesting to add in time dilation as a mechanic, but it's in a good spot for a mini project. You can try out the game for free with the link in the description. There are three levels, and you can get bronze, silver, or gold medals for each level depending on how fast you complete it. Thank you all for watching the video. Until next time.